actually is a dog, is a cat, or is a scammer, or is a true, authentic, reliable supplier, right? So the authenticity of integrity of seller's product information, authenticity of the integrity of buyer's product information, multi-trust issue, and plus international trade documentation procedures are very complex and costly. And the international buyer's management and time cost, all of those is a really painful process in international trade. So before the blockchain, we have a solution. Solution is use our own system, China Direct Sourcing. We designed the three stages of importing process. And then I want to share with you the limitation of our current solution. China Direct Sourcing is a leading sourcing firm in Australia. We make it possible for all companies of all sizes to buy direct from factory in China and export to China. We help our customer to buy from button to producer. Whatever our customer want, we help them source in China. We don't buy and sell product. If it is, you know, this is the cost of $1 in China, you pay $1. And it's all transparent and very independent. We have won so many different awards, you name it, we literally have it. Not only that, and we have, you know, over 1,000 customers and small and medium and even public listed company like, you know, Brisbane City Council and you know, Apollo Motorhome, etc. We are also the global service partner of the Alibaba. We are the only one in whole Australia. And not only that, and this is our unique three stages of importing process we designed to help our customer minimize the risk. Number one, research and tender. Number two, sampling. Number three, 2B, purchase order negotiation. And number three is production and delivery management. In stage one, we help our customer contact more than 30 suppliers. Our supplier prepare the request for quote and shortlist the prominent supplier. And our client will get the supply summary report, who is actually in this market. Not only that, we help them to prepare a quote summary report, such as, you know, you mentioned about international price, good international price, and local price. And not only that, and then we also help our customer to gain the benefit of the fair market price, have the extensive negotiation power, and have a backup plan. And we also help our client to do a land investment analysis, how much it's going to be when it's landed in Australia, and etc. Then in stage 2A, we organize a sample on behalf of our client and send the samples to selected supplier. We have our China office and they are in China and help us to solve all of those. And when we select the supplier, it's not only just the price. We also look at the history, the experience, track record, capability, ability to follow instruction, quality of the workmanship, service level, and the person managing the project. So therefore, once the supplier is selected, we help them to draft the purchase order, send the purchase order to our client, and then our client approve it with the quality control procedures, terms of payment, price increases, mode of ownership, dispute resolution, quality issue, intellectual property ownership, packaging requirement, and delivery delay. And then in the stage three, we help our client place the purchase order, arrange the supply payment, monitor the purchase order progress, help the supplier do the self-assessment, organize delivery, organize customer clearance, and deliver to our customer's door. So then after that, we also have different inspection options to assist our clients. The limitation of our current solution, we are a centralized solution. We rely on well-trained China Direct team member, both in China and Australia. We only can service very limited customer a year. So we've been in business for nearly 15 years, but so far we only have 1,000 customer. And take a lot of effort to facilitate one transaction. And repeat documentation are still there. Cross-border payment issue still maintains unresolved. And the legal complexity is unresolved. only certain customers can afford our services, even though I have write a book and a DVD about it. So the solution, wisdom blockchain. Ta-da! The new technology appeared. We are so excited. So what is blockchain? What blockchain can do to our international trade? How to design a blockchain solution for our business? And the solution with the blockchain. So give you a little bit of basics about the blockchain. You see, the internet, you can transfer the email, the voice, the video, but you can't use the internet to transfer the money. Yes? By split second, I send you an email, you received it. I split second, I send you a picture, you have it. But the problem is, I still have that picture. I still have that file. If I send you the money by current internet, you have it, I have it, it's called double spending. So that's why in previous technology, use the internet to send in the money, people tried it and it didn't work. So in year 2008, Nakamoto Sakatoshi, and he developed this blockchain technology. And the blockchain is a software protocol. It just as SMTP is a protocol for sending the email, blockchain is a protocol for sending the money. As simple as that. Everyone heard about Bitcoin? Mm-hmm. Yes. So as you can see, the application layer sending the email, the protocol layer is SMTP. You don't have to know the SMTP, but you can use the email, yeah? And then the phone call, the Skype, the application layer is phone call, the protocol layer is VoIP. That's the technology behind it. And the Bitcoin and the technology behind it is the blockchain. And all the infrastructure layer is the internet, the decentralized network. So, as you can see, the information internet has developed in the past 20 to 40 years. The killer app is the corporate email. And now we are going to go to the era we call money internet era. So, how would that look like? The blockchain supply chain in international trade. The blockchain have all the assets digitized and registered to do blockchain and instantaneously tractable on a global basis. All assets exist in digital inventory, tradable, and more importantly, findable in the global digital network economy. As you can see, the blockchain's new technology progression 1.0 is a basic better horse. 2.0 is advanced horseless carriage. The 3.0 is a future car. How will that look like? We are going to go to the next stage very soon. So with the blockchain technology and international trade, blockchain technology has brought new solution to our industry. This is so exciting, which is transforming the sharing of the information from that provided by the classical internet to the value sharing provided by a decentralized trust. And Bitcoin was the first generation of cyber currency utilizing blockchain technology. And our frethan coin and frethan chain is based on distributed technology, can measure the trading behavior of each stakeholder and its contribution at the macro level, and provide corresponding incentive or penalties through frethan chain. So, how to design the blockchain solution for the business? The frethan blockchain is a platform with international trade certificate story as its core business. The platform also includes application functions such as product display, seller certification, buyer certification, online sampling, online purchasing, token payment, smart contract, Intel trading system function, community interaction, and a credit system. So, when we design the blockchain solution for the business, number one need to have is the vision. Where did you see your business heading? What problem are you actually solving? You know, where do you actually provide and add value to? And then second is look at the ecosystem. system of the business cycle. You know, issuing the token circulation, it is only a small part of the whole ecosystem, because token have many different functions, such as incentivize, manage the ecosystem, like have hot start, and also raising the funds. You can have a B2B level, you can have a B2C level. And so therefore, when you design the blockchain solution for your business, you really need to, you know, look at how to develop the ecosystem first, and then use the token as the lubricant and to make every single part works. And then look at, will the technology really support your vision or not? Blockchain is not everything, okay? Blockchain is a technology you use while can advance, you know, the business, but it's not a solution for everything. So when we look at the international trade, and we have, you know, currently TradeLens, which is the project developed by IBM and Marsec, and the trade community system divided by PwC and the Brisbane Port and Australia Industry and the Chamber. And then we have the frethan project developed by China Direct Sourcing. Three of us complement each other. One is the digital shipping. One is for the, you know, the port, and one is for the Chinese supplier part where we focus on. You see, on the procurement side, you have sourcing, you have a procurement, and so purchasing, each part need to be like work seamlessly. So solution with the blockchain in TradeLens is an open neutral platform underpinned by blockchain technology, supported by IBM and ASEC. It's a shipping business, digitization of the shipping. And the trade community system is a platform where participants in the supply chain can share information securely in order to drive productivity and service innovation through trusted end-to-end visibility of the supply chain. So for frethan chain, we are, the backbone is China Direct Sourcing, the only global service partner of Alibaba in Australia, dealing with small and medium-sized business in Australia for the last 15 years, served more than 1,000 customers. It's a certificate storage platform for international trade. As you can see, why all the electronic data need to be stored and verified? Because when you're sending the information to other people, it can easily be become invalid and easily be changed. Even a resume or a like certificate, a graduation certificate, you can easily, you know, mark around and change it. So, right? So therefore, for us, if we store and verify those data, it can then be used for lawsuit and mediation, evidence sharing. Remember, if the data sent by case, if we had the frethan ready at that time, that issue can be solved like that. Because all those data actually stored in the system. Not only that, you can see in China, the judicial application of blockchain in China, in 7th of September, the High Court actually already issued the authenticity of the verified evidence collected by way of blockchain. In Hangzhou, they accepted the blockchain, provided the evidence, and in December, Beijing Internet Court launched the electronic evidence platform of blockchain on December. So our application, we have a sales function, have a pull function, have a buy function, volunteer function, promote function, and arbitrators function. And for our platform, we have identity, authentication, process of maintenance, certificate storage of data, data verification, and the legal services. Not only that, we have a reliable service because it's an authentic identity, identified operation, authentic process, and the traceability of those results. And therefore, we do have an advantage as on a frethan platform, such as a traceable, secure, and immutable, and also with a smart contract. As you can see, this is one of our like demo, and it's still in Chinese. The frethan data storing legal recognition. And once you submit your document, as you can see here, this gives you a hash value on blockchain, and the hash value for this document says that your certificate has been stored successfully, okay, into our system. And this is an electronic contract as well. And then also you can apply for judicial expertise services. And our client has actually now, like this about 3.2, will be listed on the quantum broker. And in future, what we actually are developing is we have six stages of development. So literally, if you look at the prison, we are only focused on the Chinese supplier. We controlled China. We controlled the world. Because China is the manufacturing hub of the world. So therefore, if we are able to verify all the Chinese supplier, then we will be able to say now it's China and Australia. And then later on, China will be like the USA. And then would be China, New Zealand. And then China, like the, UK. So this is our sixth, the only level one development. And then level two development, as you can see, would be China, so China, Australia is level one. Level two is China to other country. And the level three, we would look at, like say, Vietnam and, you know, two other country. And then level four, and then we would develop Australia to China and etc. So as you can see, the frethan will have a much wider use. Not only that, imagine, remember, I mentioned about the China Direct Sourcing Services. Use our stage one to stage three services. It costs about 3K to 10K for our service fee, yes? Guess, once we have our frethan chain developed and for our customer to use some similar service before they pay 3 to 10K, how much they will pay? They would pay probably around $50 to $100 a month. Can you imagine? The reason we can do that is because the labor, the China Direct Sourcing Services model is a labor intensive model. And the reason we have to charge that much money is because we have that much labor and then we have to use people even in China. It's a labor intensive work. But once we developed the blockchain, then you can see all the searching, all the, you know, processes, we have AI and we have a blockchain and we can do all those smart data, and then every Chinese supplier would be actually verified. Once that's done, our cost can be dramatically dropped. And then this will pass to our client. Can you see our client base will increase from 1,000 to
10,000?
1,000 times more. Can you see that? So therefore, that's why we say China Direct Sourcing, it is now at the most critical moment. And the good news is we have raised enough funds for our the first round seed fundraising. And then we have already developed our frethan Chinese platform. And it has already been accepted by 16 different judicial departments in China and widely accepted. Not only that, and we are now to probably next 6 months, we are developing our frethan chain's English interface, and by that time it will be ready. And then we also developing the, from now, next 6 months, we are doing the three steps. One is to finish our design brief and doing the frethan wallet, okay? We designed our own wallet, and this will be used and be ready to use for 6 months. Number two, and we will finish our English interface for the frethan chain, and we will have a demo by that time. And number three, in the meantime, we will work, we received many Chinese government invitations, and we will actually have our project endorsed by the Chinese government. Remember, I shared about the news, Chinese government loved the blockchain project. Frethan project actually tick all the boxes to gain their favorites. Why? One, when we go to the China, we are truly a blockchain project. Two, when we actually in China, we can help the Chinese business exporting their products back to Australia and then back to all over the world. We will increase the reputation of the Chinese supplier and dramatically, because everyone who come to the frozen would be verified. And so therefore, you don't need to trust the particular supplier, you trust the platform, therefore to increase the volume of the whole transaction. And so number four, any particular government who invite us to go to their provinces, they provide funding. So in return, we help them to help the local business to increase dramatically. So can you see why we are so popular in China? And so we really get the popularity and we've been loved by our supplier, by the government, by our customer. And we just felt it's such a great opportunity for China Grand Sourcing for Frozen. We're in the golden time. And I couldn't ask for anything better. So in summary, I have shared with you the background of the international trade, the challenges facing our industry, and the solutions before the blockchain, and the solutions with the blockchain. And in my view, Frozen is going to have a bright future. We are going to really, truly fly. Thank you. And